Hey Capricorn, welcome to my channel if you're new, and welcome back if you've been here before. Sorry, I just kind of was just making sure my computer doesn't fall off my desk. Anyways, welcome to my channel. Thank you for being part of the Soul Tribe here at my channel. I hope you're doing really great, Capricorn, and just to let you know, this reading is a general reading for you for the month of August 2022, or whenever you're called to listen to this reading. We're just going to get started. Let's begin. I'm going to be opening up with a new deck that I have, which is called The Secret Language of Color. Beautiful deck. I have been wanting a color deck for a very long time, and magically I stumbled on it, and it is gorgeous. If you don't know, I am an abstract artist, so colors have always been a very important part of my vibration since the time I was little. So let's get into it and see how this deck can help you. And then once I pull a card from Spirit, we will do a Celtic cross, all right? So let's begin. Spirit for Capricorn, our gorgeous earth sign for the month of August 2022, or whenever they are needing this reading, let us get a color card and see what they can be working with. Show Capricorn clearly what message they are needing. Capricorn. Bronze. Okay. Strengthen your body. And Capricorn, when I started after I split the deck, this was on the bottom. I just didn't say anything. So it was definitely meant for it to come out for you. And on the bottom we have Cian, which is build your confidence. So we're gonna take both. Now I'll show you these cards quickly and then we'll talk about it. But I wanna get the Celtic cross pulled. Bronze, this is all about strengthening your physical body. I'm really picking up on that energy for you. It's obviously bronze. There may be some kind of thing you're dealing with physical. You know, for some of you, I'm just really feeling this need to have a massage. I feel like your body is tired. I feel like your muscles are sore. My neck is kind of aching a little bit here. So this feels like for a lot of you that there may be a need for you to take some time to just, if you can, get a massage. Get a foot rub, something like that to release some toxins that I'm feeling are in your body. We also have Cian and beautiful blue, bright color, but this is about building your own confidence. Strong energy here. So you may be feeling, you know, what I'm picking up here for some of you, Capricorn, is you've started some kind of new career here, and it may involve your body, you know. You may be physically having to do stuff that is kind of wearing your body out a little bit, but at the same time, you may have a bit of... I'm getting the energy that you might not feel super confident about this new role that you may be in, okay? So we'll see as we go into the Celtic cross what is coming out and what's going on for you, Capricorn. But these are two energies and two colors that if you wish, you can actually focus where, have around you, blue candle, bronze candle. I'm just picking that because those are pretty easy to get, even from a Dollar Tree, dollar kind of store. But just to have around you so that you can just allow that vibration of each color to envelop around your vibration, to allow your body to strengthen, to allow this confidence, inner confidence, to start shining through, because you are beautiful, Capricorn. And although I know we all go through periods in our life where maybe we're not so confident about a relationship, about a career move, you know, wherever we're at, we might have moments of self-doubt. I really just want you to understand and know that Spirit is coming through here to let you know that you have got everything it takes to make your life the way you want it. But there is this indication here that some of you really may be needing to get, like I said, a massage. But it's also even further than that. It's about strengthening your body. Okay, we're going to leave it there. They just said stop, so I'm going to stop. All right, let's get into Celtic spread and see what's going on for you guys. All right. For Capricorn, show me clearly, Spirit. The Two of Swords was on the bottom of the deck. All right. Okay, we've got the Eight of Swords, Three of Pentacles, and the Three of Wands. This is past, this is present, this is future. I want to see what is crossing you, your challenge. What is the challenge for Capricorn? Let's move this down a bit for our Celtic cross. What is the challenge? You're working on something here, so what is the challenge? A High Priestess, Pisces card, okay. See, this is feeling like you're not trusting yourself, Capricorn. All right, let's see what is above you, what you're conscious of. Seven of Wands, okay. And what are you not aware of? Capricorn. The Seven of Swords, okay. Ooh, too many cards, Spirit. Let's get advice from Spirit. The Star, okay. All right, the Star, all right. Outside influence, Ten of Pentacles. Wow, hopes and fears, the Sun. Outcome, Eight of Wands. Things are gonna be moving fast. Bottom of the deck, we've got the Queen of Pentacles. All right. I don't have enough room on my desk, so I'm just going to put it like this. Okay, let's get into your reading. Whew, this is really beautiful and positive, Capricorn. All right, bottom of the deck, we have the Queen of Pentacles. This is the overall energy of your reading here. Queen of Pentacles is your sign. You're showing up here. This is our money. It is our self-worth. It is the material things. Queen of Wands, as the main influence underneath your reading, is really saying loud and clear that you are you have the capability to achieve everything that you want, including to make a lot of money here. She is wealthy, she is grounded, she is nurturing, she's loving, and she does not worry. She knows her worth, she knows her ability, and she knows that she will continue to make a lot of money here. So even though you may be feeling a little apprehensive, is the word they're giving me, in whatever this is relating to, feels more career, but could be in any area. You actually, deep down inside, Capricorn, you know how amazing you are. You do know that you are capable of so much wonderful things. Center of the reading is the Three of Pentacles. It's working. It's working together with other people, typically two other people, because it's the Three of Pentacles. Collaboration, really bringing skills, gifts, talents all together to create a bigger outcome. It is crossed by the High Priestess, and this is where I feel like you are questioning yourself. It's almost like you are, because it is a challenge position, it's almost like you're not really believing what your intuition is telling you. You're not really listening to that highest wisdom that exists within you, Capricorn, and you're kind of doubting yourself here a bit. So that is your challenge over this time, is to tap in more to what your gut is telling you, to really allow your confidence to shine through in a big, beautiful way, not to minimize yourself, to maximize yourself, to really show yourself, most importantly, that you can do anything you want. You can achieve anything. If you're doing some new job here that is involving your body, for example, for some of you, I'm feeling it. I feel like you're working out in nature. You're somewhere, you're doing, now evidently that's not gonna be for everyone, but I feel like there's like, there's this need that you're having to utilize your actual physical body, your muscles, your flexibility. And it can be quite exhausting, especially if this is a new path that you've stepped on. So they are telling you to strengthen your body. And there's many ways you can do that. I'm not going to go into that, right? But you can, you know, you can do a lot of things. Even just going for walks and stuff strengthens your body and your endurance, and really makes your muscles more flexible, so you're not so stiff if you are going through that kind of, if you're in that kind of situation, right? But they're saying it is time for you to strengthen your body and also build your confidence. So the more you start to trust your intuition and you start to tap into that, the more quicker all of this beautiful, these beautiful things are going to start to come your way. When we look at your past, it is represented by the Eight of Swords. Eight of Swords is that feeling stuck, not really feeling like you have an option here. Could even be that you've applied for a job and you know that it's something different that you've never done before, and you might be scared and it might have made you fearful. So that is where the shift in your mind and listening to your gut is going to get you out of that. When we look at what is above you, what you're aware of, there is a self-defense. It's Seven of Wands. It's like you're defending yourself. You're keeping yourself kind of almost closed off. I don't know if that's because you're concerned that other people are going to critique you. Perhaps you've been critiqued a lot in your past, so there's a bit of a residue that is coming through on that. But there is this energy of you're like, I'm not going to expose myself completely. I'm not going to expose my vulnerability here. I think it's like you don't want to be judged here in some way. When we look at what you don't know, we have the Seven of Swords. Now, two ways we can take this, Capricorn. It could be that someone is around you that may be sabotaging you. Seven of Swords is a sneaky energy. It's a tricky energy. It can even mean someone trying to steal from you. I don't feel like you're aware of it, though, because it is in the subconscious position. Now, it could be someone else, or this could be you, right? Sometimes when we are doing things and it's unknown, it's foreign to us, it's a new start, it's a new job, it's a new path, whatever it may be, we can actually almost talk ourselves out of it. And that, in a way, is like almost betraying ourselves, because we're not allowing ourselves to actually embrace the fact that we are so capable of a lot more than what our mind tells us, right? Our mind can be, it can be the fire starter to create amazing things, but it also can be, you know, that fire that burns away the positive and we get wrapped up in negative thinking. So it will apply differently for each of you, but there is some kind of energy that is almost like a sabotage energy going on. Your near future, though, it's like the Three of Wands. I think you figure this out. You start to get pretty clear in your mind and really start to trust your intuition, and you start to head out in a new direction. Three of Wands is going, okay, hey, I don't know how this is going to work out, but I'm still going to trudge ahead. I'm still going to go for it. I'm going to take that risk. I'm going to take that jump, and I'm going to put my whole self into it, even though I don't know where it's ending up. Advice from Spirit is Aquarius's card. It is the Star. So this is powerful, because it is the energy that Spirit is saying, look, past hurts, past regrets, things that you've done in the past that maybe perhaps didn't work out the way you thought they were going to be, that's okay. There was lessons that you were learning through that, and there were things that you had to go through in order to get you to this more powerful place. And the Star showing up is saying, look, just allow yourself to almost forgive yourself. Like, don't worry about the times where you felt you screwed up. You know, that still helps us expand and grow. The Star also showing up is saying that there's hope. You know, have hope, have faith, believe in your dream. You know, it's a Star card, so wish upon that star and then believe in what you wished, right? So that it can start to come towards you. Now, outside influence is the Ten of Pentacles. So I feel like there's people around you that want to cheer you on, that are wanting the best for you. And I also feel that the Ten of Pentacles is representing what you are really wanting to achieve here. You want to be successful, and you want to have, you know, great abundance, and you want to be successful. Your hopes and your fears, the Sun, I feel like this is really your hope. I highly doubt you'd fear the Sun showing up in your reading. Your hope is that the Sun is going to shine on you. And it is, Capricorn. It truly is. You are wanting the freedom, the abundance, the success and the joy and the happiness and the ability to really do what you want to do with full, beautiful self-confidence, with your body feeling like you can do anything in the world that you want to. And it's like that is what is you are aspiring to get to. And it looks like it comes in fast, because we have the Eight of Wands. Now, Eight of Wands is that very focused energy that happens quite quickly. And I always relate Eight of Wands is, especially with the Sun and the Ten of Pentacles and the Star right in this row, I feel like this is good new opportunities and successful growth happening quite quick, quite fast. The only thing that Spirit is advising you is believe in yourself a little bit more, Capricorn. It's not going to hurt anything. Believe that you can do it, and you will, you know? Gorgeous cards around here. Very positive vibrational energy that is coming through on this reading. Tap more into your intuition and trust what your intuition is telling you. Don't sabotage yourself, and also don't allow anyone to sabotage you. The Ten of Pentacles, you know, that is a happy home, happy family, right? This could also be indicating that you may have family or close friends or people that you consider family. They might also be kind of not really supporting you in some way. They might actually be raining on your parade. Maybe you're wanting to do something different, out of the norm, something that, you know, maybe you want to be an artist, maybe you want to do tarot readings, you know, maybe it's something that might be a little taboo to what your family would think is acceptable, okay? Because sometimes there are energies in this world that don't always allow for a lot of flexibility and a lot of different variances of how we make our living or what we're doing. So for some of you, and it might only be a few of you, there may be some kind of family influence here that is kind of keeping you a little bit stuck in some way. But don't fear, don't worry, because you're going to get what you want as long as you make room for it to come towards you. Okay, I want to get a little bit of clarifiers. I think we'll use my fountain deck here. All right, Spirit, what else? Added information, guidance, advice for Capricorn. And then we're just going to go freestyle here. I'm not going to clarify any individual card at this moment. I'm just going to see what Spirit wants to come out. What other information, advice, guidance could you offer our gorgeous Capricorn regarding this reading? You know, I just did Sagittarius's reading, and it was about brilliance. It was about shining your light brightly. And they're giving that energy again a bit here. So perhaps you have a Sagittarius placement. If you do, I highly suggest you go listen to it. Sun, Moon, Rising, and Venus. That all helps you paint a bigger picture of what is really actually going on for you. Okay, we have the Knight of Cups. That just came out beautiful. And we have the Two of Swords again on the bottom of the deck, as I had on my Lightseer's deck. There is a struggle for you. I feel like you're fighting between going after what you want and, like, between your head and your heart. Like, going after what you really feel in your heart is going to be good for you. But what your mind is telling you is a different route, a different way. And there may be people around you trying to get you to stay on, you know, the traditional route, okay? Spirit is saying differently. Spirit is saying, Knight of Cups, do what you love to do. Do what lights your heart up. And do it with full abandonment. Don't worry about the criticism. Don't worry about the ifs, the whats, the ands, the whatever. It is all going to work out for you, because this is the path that you're meant to take. All right. Anything else for Capricorn? I mean, these are you have a lot of beautiful blessings that are coming towards you, if not already making themselves aware in your life. Anything else? Capricorn. Okay, that's quite a few. Well, we've got the Ace of Coins on the bottom. This is a beautiful new beginning in your finances. Can be a windfall card too. So this could be promising here that there's a lot of money coming towards you, especially with the Queen of Pentacles on the bottom of my Lightseer's deck. Now, sorry, I'm just getting very claustrophobic. What the hell am I saying? Oh my God, Spirit, guide me right. I'm getting congested is the word. We have the Eight of Cups. Yes, walking away and leaving behind the people, the places, the situations, the inner talk, the self-doubt. You're walking away from being disconnected to yourself. You're leaving it behind. You're moving on a new path. We have the Four of Coins, but they're in reverse. Upright, Five of Coins is all about lack, poverty, not enough, not feeling good enough. You know, feeling just like you have nothing. Oops, showing you the wrong card. Capricorn, your energy, what's going on? I'm picking up. That's the lack card, Five of Pentacles. But it also came out with the Four of Coins, which is holding on tight to only what you know, because you're afraid that there might not be anything better out there, right? But they both come out in reverse, which tells me here, especially with the Eight of Cups, it's like you're leaving that behind. you're not going to allow any more doubt to come in your life, and you're going to go after what it is you want. That's as simple as I can put it. You're done with feeling like you just got to do the tried and true. You're done with that. You want to expand. You want to do your own thing here. And you really want to go after what is going to really make you feel contentment, you know? So build your confidence up. That way, no one can ever touch you. You know, as long as you believe in yourself, that is all truly that matters, is what you think of yourself, not what other people think. What they think is their business. It is not yours. So Capricorn, major change, major opportunity here for you to really live your life the way you want. Strengthen your body. For some reason, this just keeps coming through. Now, that doesn't mean like, oh, you got to go to the gym 7 days a week or anything like that. Do whatever it is that makes you feel strong in your body. Because when you feel confident and you feel strong in your body, you walk with a different energy. You know, head up, shoulders back, proud of who you are, proud of what you represent, and proud of where you are heading. That in itself creates this attraction, you know? All of a sudden, everyone's attracted to Capricorn because Capricorn is just so beautiful and so radiating in their beautiful self-confidence. So I feel like that is a message Spirit really wants to drive home. And again, Capricorn, I don't even know how to say that. Cyan? I guess it's cyan. You know, I see it all the time when I'm painting. C-Y-A-N, cyan. I guess that's how you say it. But I never think about how to say it. Those colors, very potent for you. Wear them, you know? Wear them as often as you can over these next few weeks. It'll just empower you that much more. All right, let's close this reading off for Capricorn Spirit. What final advice, message, guidance do you have for this reading? Okay, let me just grab, where did that one go? Here we go. We've got trust. Trust has come out. No fear. Trust yourself, your knowing, your intuition, your wholeness. Move with certainty. Be sure of yourself. Now may be decision time. It is only fear that could hold you back now. When you know that there is no such thing as a wrong decision, you will trust yourself joyfully. It is time to trust in the process of growth. Let go, allow, and flow. You just might enjoy it. Beautiful way to close this reading for you, Capricorn. Trust. Trust the process. More importantly, trust yourself. Trust yourself. Because this is a challenge, High Priestess. So I hope this helps in some way. I almost said Sagittarius. So some of you Capricorns have a Sagittarius placement for sure. Go check it out. I think these two readings could really go together quite well. Okay. Thank you so much. I love you. I appreciate you. I invite you to become part of the CJ Soul Tribe here. If this resonated, I'd love to have you back here at another time. In the meantime, Capricorn, go enjoy your life, have fun, and take good care. We'll see you next time.